They didn't do anything worthwhile yesterday, so it's Tuesday morning. Coming to see good old Doc G. See if he can help me with my crabby arm. This is the magic magnet. I think Twitch and Matto and AC all bought this machine. More guys than that, actually. Doc G's in there dropping a deuce. And when he comes out, we'll get him to explain it. Tell me what it's doing.
So this is called pulsed electromagnetic frequency, and it creates a huge amount of magnet current going in through the trauma area, which is like a big old, inflamed ball right there. So it draws the inflammation out. We use it on, acute situations, shoulders, elbows, wrists, and it's probably one of the best modalities we have to draw inflammation in an area that has trauma. So when the guys crash, like all the moto guys do, they'll put it on their shoulder, put it on their wrist, ankle, and it just draws out the inflammation better than most of the stuff that we have here.
It's better than when you strip by hand, right?
Well, I mean, there's the purposes for everything, but like in this situation like yours, the last thing you want to do is be stripping that, that area, because there's so much trauma to it. So we use modalities like lasers and acoustic sound wave and the PEMF machine to draw out the inflammation, because we can't do hands-on stuff to that area. So
yeah.
The next best thing.
Well, thank you as always, G.
My pleasure.
I just watched a video of you going over the bars off the dragon's back. Yeah.
I should have just hit the front brake and tucked into the front foot.
How's it feeling?
Just sore, man.
Yeah.
Really sore. Took a pretty hard digger to my shoulder, but I'm alright.
Be all right this weekend?
I don't know. I'm in a lot of pain right now.
So yeah.
I'm just gonna be in here every day to see how I feel. You know? When I crashed at Oakland, I didn't think I was gonna race the next weekend either. So, And I did it same day. I got sick. So maybe I just need some more time off and I'll feel better.
You want to go to CVAC with me and A-Ray today?
No. Where are you going?
CVAC.
I'll see you soon.
That pressure chamber thing?
I heard VAC, and I just figured HVAC, dude, like my dad.
No. CVAC. Did you see my nice little arm?
Heck yeah, dude.
Dude, looked like a baseball in there, huh? So, okay, you were wearing a Team Fried t-shirt.
Yeah.
And a DBK hoodie. So this is like merch dealers support each other, right?
Oh, yeah. I think so. I mean, I really like the Team Fried videos and everything, but
yeah.
Obviously DBK is freaking, everyone loves DBK.
Yeah. So.
Got to mix it up.
I was talking about on the podcast, but
yeah.
Saturday, I wore my Saturdays Are for Supercross t-shirt.
Yeah.
Dude, it's spelled wrong.
No.
No, not spelled wrong, but it's Saturdays Are for Supercross. You have Saturday apostrophe S.
That's
possessive.
No.
Yeah. It should just be a S, no apostrophe.
Okay, bye, you guys. Have a good day.
Well, hey, we'll look into that.
You look into that. It's that homeschool design group.
Yeah.
Right?
Really hitting it hard.
So have you been here at G's every day?
Yep. Every day.
He's the best guy, huh?
We're at the world headquarters of Dirt Bike TV. Jay Clark. Formerly known in the early days as Wisco J, but now is Wisco J again.
Back to Wisco J.
I'm kind of excited about that, Wisco J.
Yeah.
But anyway, this is like the dream garage for a dirt bike guy. Dirt bikes. Tools galore, everything you need. We got Pedro, the assistant mechanic. Assistant mechanic there. Mr. J is helping me out. I had a bald tire at Elsinore. You know what though? Bald tires hook up good on concrete.
Right. I don't know that it would matter, yeah.
No, I mean, they hook up way better than a good tire. I ripped two starts at Paris last weekend. Two weekends ago.
Are you sad to Paris? Or are you guys going to go to Paris after they redo it?
No, I don't think they're going to let us back because they don't like Aaron.
Oh, the new people don't.
Yeah. But, it's always a treat and a privilege to drop my bike here for the new The Jeff Emig Nunu.
Nunu, I like that.
Got a new pipe on my bike.
Is it Nunu?
I don't know. I don't know if I need a front. Do I need a front?
No, we can just do a rear.
I don't think I need a front. That front looks tangy.
Our budget's tight, so that's good.
Yeah. So Jay is a YouTube influencer. Where's your partner in crime? Where's Spencer?
Spencer's in Utah, going to school.
He's back in school.
Back in school.
Okay. Dirt Bike TV 2 is off studying.
Yep.
What is he studying? Video production?
No. You would think that would be the smart thing to do, right?
Yeah, it would.
No, he's talking about going in the FBI or something.
Oh, snap. There you go.
So we'll see. Okay. Like so the tools? Everybody likes the tools.
Tools, look at that.
Let's go look at sockets and... Guys love this, right?
Lots of sockets.
Screwdriver in the top drawer. And then these are the main drawers.
So when you have this many screwdrivers, do all the flatheads disappear and all you have is left Phillips?
No.
That happens to my toolbox.
So this is all Phillips flat blades over here. Uh-huh. Organized.
Tiny ones.
Yeah. And then on the wall.
Let's do a label check. Are there any typos?
Typos.
No, everything is spelled correctly. Look at that.
good buddy of mine printed those up for me.
WC Bling. Is that work connection bling?
Yeah. But I think that's...
There's no bling in here. There's just old wires and zip ties.
Yeah, we relocated some stuff.
Ah, okay. So here's Jay's channel, Dirt Bike TV.
Really old.
What do you pull in from YouTube a month now?
Oh.
Are you bringing in 10 grand?
Oh, a month?
Yeah.
No. I don't have that big a YouTube. My social's bigger.
Social's bigger, yeah.
Which is good for all my companies that I work with and represent. You can promote them. That's really the main goal.
Look, you already have a new stand sticker.
Yeah.
Weiss Go J.
Yeah. So we've been cleaning. If you look at the shop, we've got all the stickers off. We should have been trying to clean up, get rid of all the old logos.
Yeah.
And then logos like this. So we got some logos that are blocked off. We've done the factory team block off deal for temporary right now.
Yeah.
But I've had Decal Works. My graphic guys have been really working hard to get me caught back up.
Nice.
So that's been an issue. So we're going to grease the axle, right? Is this what you do every time, Don?
Every time.
Yeah, every time. Okay.
Every time I change a tire myself, so it's not that often.
Right. Okay, so we got the axle done up here.
Okay, wait. I've got a CVAC appointment I've got to get to.
Okay.
So I'll pick up. Can I ask a favor?
Yeah.
Could you determine whether my bars are bent or if my front end just needs to be loosened and straightened? Because I slammed the mat pretty hard a couple days ago.
Yeah, I'm going
to
say...
And I know that these bars are really hard to bend. I've cartwheeled this bike several times.
Do you know what you torque these to?
Well, you're supposed to torque them to...
Is it on here?
12 Newton meters.
Okay.
But you know what I did? That feels about right.
Okay.
So if you could torque those properly.
So I think what we'll do is we'll loosen the whole front end when I get it on, and then I'll go ride it and see if it feels straight.
Okay. Thank you, Jay.
Okay. See ya.
Dirt Bike TV.
Where are we going?
All right, so we're at CVAC Systems. Here in Murrieta.
Don't go through the front door.
No, JC takes care of us in the back, and it's kind of seems kind of sketchy.
Wearing shoes today?
I think it's what healed my neck. There he is. There's
of
JC.
Of course you are.
Hey,
I
JC.
I just go upstairs, you know. Hi.
This is my
good
pal.
Seeing you.
This is my my co-host of the podcast, Alex Ray.
How's it going?
What's your name?
Alex. Yeah, Alex. I've been here before.
Yeah.
All right. So, are we going here or
yep,
front?
We're going here.
Okay.
So, you've seen the front already.
Oh, yeah.
Trophies.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because, you know, this is the warehouse.
So.
And I'm sore.
This is the pre-CVAC size.
We should.
Go get smaller now, yeah. Huh? Go ahead. You got a tape measure?
This is the size of my vagina.
All right, we're ready. We're ready for liftoff.
You started.
Ready for blast off.
Start chopping an easy one so we can warm your ears up.
Yeah. I gave Alex a piece of gum.
Pardon me?
We brought gum in our mouth. So.
Oh, I can smell it. That's okay. You guys like it? Great. All right. Oh, here we go. So the CVAC takes you up to altitude and plunges you back down below sea level, and this forces your body to oxygenate your blood, which helps with recovery and reduction of inflammation. So right now my ears are popping because I haven't done this in a while, But this machine, I think, was really helpful when I broke my neck a couple years ago. I came every day for about 2 months straight.
There's Alex over there.
Alright, so I completed my first program. Before I came in, my hand was totally fat. It looked like Dahmer's hand. Now I can kind of see the definition in my hand, kind of like my left hand. Swelling's already going down. These big deals going on or bullshit?
Say hi to Daddy Frank. Your dad just walked in.
Hi, Uncle Frank.
Hey, what's up, Tiger?
Nothing.
How are you?
I'm okay. How are you living?
Dude, you'd be so fucking proud. I'm 15 pounds down this year. I'm fucking healthy and fit. I'm out there getting
it. Oh, yeah?
I was a peacock.
15 pounds down is 3/4 inch of penis.
Dude, in all honesty, that's the last thing I need is more penis.
We got that Michael Antonovich show. Brought a foo-foo coffee for our producer.
Two down.
Huh?
Two down.
Oh, it's all done? We're done?
Yep.
How is it, Mitchell?
I'm on a vlog now.
Look at this guy.
You guys in your dang vlogs.
Hey, I didn't know you were so gnarly. Let's see your arm.
Arm.
Huh? Let's see the arm.
Oh, tattoos?
Yeah.
Oh, God. You don't have any freaking...
Oh, you got leg pieces.
Leg pieces. I got sides.
I remember the first time I saw that, I was like, Freckles got ink? What?
I got my first tattoo at 16.
16? Was it a rebellion thing?
No. My mom drove me to Louisiana to get it.
No way.
Yep.
Mom took you.
Yep, for my birthday, because you can't do it in Texas or whatever, so we road trip to Shreveport and... went to this some janky tattoo shop.
That's sick.
Yeah.
That's sick. Yeah, when my kid was turning 18, she's like, I'm getting a tattoo. I said, I'll take you to get a tattoo.
Yeah.
So then I got this one the same day.
Okay.
And acted like it hurt 10 times worse than it did, and then she didn't get one.
I was dying. I got my side done first, and I was dying.
Side kills, right?
Yeah. But I'd have a lot more tattoos if I had more money, that's for sure.
Dang, dude. You're gonna have to sell some more refurbished furniture.
Yeah.
Get your next.
I'm itching to get back to Texas to do that. Actually, it's a lot of fun.
So I hear. I heard you're a super ripper on the 250.
Oh gosh, here we go.
Huh?
Feel good.
I mean, you know the bike can hole shot.
Yeah, that's been good to see. I mean, I got a couple races under my belt. Been riding the 250 good. Feeling good. I don't know. I mean.
Yeah.
Everything's going good. So.
So what do you think about Swapmoto Live becoming Senor Michael Live?
He
could
I love
just
it.
Take my place.
Anton's
I don't have to do this
dude.
Anymore.
Yeah.
I don't have to do it anymore at all.
Nah, you can do your vlogs.
I'll just vlog, vlog life.
You were driven a side by side?
Yeah.
Out of the ranch, right?
Uh-huh. But
you got a mule.
A mule. I got a mule. They run forever.
Terex has come a long way since the mule.
Yeah, but it's a Kawasaki now, so it's no good.
Yeah. Husky don't make it side by side, though.
No. They make like.
Chainsaws.
Chainsaws.
Sewing machines.
Sewing machines. Hey, what you write? And then they got a couple.
Did you get Sonya a sewing machine yet from Husky?
No, she don't sew.
She don't sew?
No.
Bro, she didn't hem your corduroys when you were little?
My grandma sews, but not my mom.
Yeah.
They make all kinds of like street bikes and stuff.
Yeah.
Which I'm not allowed to ride.
By Cowie or by parents?
No,
or
by
not
parents.
By Husky or by parents?
No, by my parents. Oh, yeah. I'm allowed a Harley, but I'm not, which I have. I have a Harley. I have a street glide.
You have a Harley?
I do. I have a street glide. But my parents don't want me to ride a street bike.
Okay. Is that why James never rode that gold Ninja?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like street bikes serve one purpose, which is wide open.
Yeah. Get killed.
I mean, yeah, you can get killed doing anything.
Driver's texting.
Yeah. No, I mean, that's why also, too, when I ride my Harley, like, I never ride by myself. Yeah. I always ride with a group of people. So maybe I'll slim my chances up.
Hey, Chase, did you hear Malcolm has a Harley?
That's good.
Huh?
That's good.
Do you wear a leather vest?
Yeah.
Or no, what, yours,
no,
what?
No, not. Oh, you wear like
leather?
Like
yours
the vest?
Denim.
You wear the
Mine's
vest.
Mine's not leather. Mine's denim.
He says he has to wear a vest because otherwise the t-shirt rubs his nipples.
It does. No, he's right. No, or you wear like a flannel kind of thing too.
Yeah.
Like I got a leather vest just because the thing looks cool. But
you never posted a picture of it on your Instagram. I didn't know you had a Harley.
I mean, just. Don't.
Is it stock or is it all daddied out?
No, I bought a CVO.
What's a CV? You know what a CV is?
That's like a
Ferrari and a Harley, basically.
So it's like a Cadillac version of
you
it.
You do wheelies on it?
No.
Thank God. Custom he does wheelies vehicle, on his.
What is it? Custom vehicle option?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. I forget. We're going to have to look it up what a CVO stands for. But
how long you had it?
I just bought it. It's bought at 17.
You've had it a while.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. So I've had it for a little while now. And I mean, every now and then I'll take it out, me and my dad. If we're still in, like, Daytona has this thing called Biketoberfest.
Yeah.
Dude, like, I'll get Zach Freeberg go down, a couple of other buddies will go down, and it's, like, a big deal. Like, it's like bike week, but, like, I feel like it's actually bigger than bike week, to be honest, for Daytona.
Okay, do you wear a showy full-face street bike helmet, or do you wear like one of those little joke helmets?
I wear like a half shell.
Like the German helmet looking thing?
Yeah.
And
I run a face mask too. Like I have like a skull
face. A skull face?
Yeah.
Do you have a shirt that says if you can read this, the bitch fell off?
Nah, because I wear either the leathers or the flannel looking.
How about Loud Pipes Save Lives? You have that shirt?
No, I run Vance Hines.
Pipes. Oh, you got Vance and Hines pipe.
Yeah. Dude, I got my stuff decked out, man. I ain't gonna lie.
is there a fishing pole rock on that one?
No, ain't no fishing pole. I'm gonna start calling myself Night Rider. Sleep all day, ride at night.
Did you see my fat hand this weekend?
No, what'd you do?
I fell at Elsinore. I had a monkey bump like that.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Dude, you fall a lot.
All right, we good?
Every time I see you, you got road rash or fucking bumped your head or swollen arm or something.
Hey, man. Here for a good time, not a long time.
That's right. Go hard or go home.
Hold it, Crooks, with Renee.
Again?
It's been 2 days, two and a half days of pretty intensive therapy stuff on my arm. It's looking better, I think. Still a little jiggly right there. And the hand's still fat. I still can't. Oh, hey, I got some mobility just now riding. I can make a fist. That means I could pull the front brake. But couldn't stay off the bicycle. Had to get out. I was trying to talk shit like I was going to ride Monday morning, but I woke up and everything hurt too much. And my arm was gigantic. But thanks to Doc G, JC at CVAC, and Derek at Ohana Wellness. Got looking better. Oh my God, this hurts. Morning, get a bite. Thank you.
killing that. Dusting out. Leave a message already.
Got it, because it's the sickest kid he's ever seen.
Was this like option?
Tell me how cool this thing looks. Tell me. It's
wrong. It's supposed to say Maeda.
Oh, fucking God.
I almost died in that.
like the traditional race look better. Gray backgrounds, black numbers. Why even have numbers when you can't see them?
I'm stealth like that.
Huh?
I'm stealth like that.
You don't want to get scored?
Well, when you're in the back, it doesn't matter if you're getting
scored. Oh, wait. You don't race. So there's decoration.
I raced day in the dirt.
You did.
You fucking
died. You did. You didn't have a kit then.
I didn't have a kit yet because you didn't help me out yet. I wasn't SML.
Hey, seriously though, backyard shit goes on good, huh?
It was pretty good.
It's
I can't
easy
lie.
To install.
It was pretty good, yeah. I even put on my first seat cover ever.
Oh.
And you pretty much have to do two of them because of the little guy up front.
The little guy, yeah.
Go look at it. It's so perfect.
You know, I thought there might be an SML logo on this since I got them for you.
Look at it closely. There's no SML logo.
How's the wrist?
I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna race.
No?
No bueno?
No.
How do you feel?
I feel fine.
Yeah?
Dude, it's almost normal. So yeah. You know, I saw the pictures. Did you take it to Pound Town?
No Pound Town. Her dad's a cop, so I'm trying to stay away from that area right now.
I was proud of you, dude.
Yeah, dude, she's hot, bro.
Oh, what? You still got the same one?
No,
not clip that one.
No, are we on cam right now?
It's off, if, right?
No, okay. It's on. But oh. If all the ladies are watching, I'm single. So
you're single?
What's up? Are you coming this weekend?
What?
Are you coming this weekend?
Yeah.
There will be a girl at the SGB tent that's like same, might be close to the same nationality as you.
Yeah, the one you're the halfer that you got a crush on.
Are you filming that busted ass vlog? Scrub Daddy Films?
Man, come on, man.
Huh?
No, the kids want me to keep going, so.
Come on, you got like 800 views.
I'm not doing it for the views. I'm only doing it for the fans.
For the fans. All 800 of them.
Yo.
I know that. I know that.
You know A-Ray's out here, right?
I saw him. He's not racing. He said his wrist hurts.
Hey,
A-Ray is soft like Scrub Daddy. I ain't racing. Right?
Oh, you agree?
Yeah, he agrees. He knows. He knows soft when he sees soft.
Well, all I know is this. I just want to get a couple shots of him out there. And you won't ride.
I'm already done.
You done? You only did one moto.
No, I just wanted to see if my arm could handle it.
So you ain't gonna do no more? Casey said he waiting on you.
Yeah. ain't waiting on shit. He ain't waiting on anything but a positive pregnancy test.
Oh, that's good.
They're trying to crank out babies already.
Damn.
Him and my niece.
That's nice.
All right, let's ask him.
It's going good.
Have you bought a test yet?
Oh, about 30 of them.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah.
They're all negative so far?
All negative.
You know why? He needs to relax when he does it. He rides drag
racing. It's like a drag race, bro.
Yeah, see, you gotta go in there and go slow. She's already yours, so you don't have to.
Hey man. Wait, you can't be talking about my niece like this. I know, but still. You talk about going to Pound Town with my niece.
No, I'm talking about him taking his time.
Hey, just remember who brought this subject up.
That's
both,
true.
Both of you.
I just wanted to know, like, if I would be
a great uncle?
A great uncle, yeah.
Yeah, that's the plan.
Okay.
Maybe twice. But no more than that. If we have twins straight out of the gate, that's it.
Clear.
If we have one child and then twins, I'm gonna sell one of them.
Did you get any hate mail or death threats or?
No, no one knows I exist.
Nick Mack. Nick Mack is the mechanic responsible for the clash.
100% responsible. Entirely my doing.
It is.
Yeah, we'll be turning you right here through that hole.
Perfect.
Cool.
All right.
Can we go check it out? We got a few minutes?
Yeah, about 1:30 we'll be doing two 10-minute sessions, 450s first, then 250s, then 450s, then 250s. Take care, bud.
What do you think?
Look at this.
I think, that's sick. You guys getting paint your helmets?
Yeah, right?
What was the feedback on your interview? I saw a lot of good comments.
Yeah, good. I was going to tell you thank you for coming out to do that. Thought it was good to get my voice out there. It took a few days for us to do anything. I kind of just went back and went straight to work and did my normal routine to take my mind off everything. So it took a few days longer than what
we just turned everything off.
Yeah, just should have maybe addressed it sooner, but I said my side and done with it now. And let's go racing.
Dude, this is the best kit I've seen.
I like it, huh? Yeah. Probably gonna get the most pictures I'm gonna get all year right now, so put the good stuff on and
looks good,
bring
though.
The fresh helmet out.
I like the logos that are painted.
Yeah.
I like this one. Did you get a bike yet?
I guess they're on their way right now.
Nice.
Yeah.
What did you request?
E-bike. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. I've been
we'll go shred gear on that.
Yeah,
thing,
for sure. I've been wanting one for so long. There's so many days where I'm like, I'd love to go up there and ride, but like I don't want to pedal to the top, or I gotta ride tomorrow. I'm not gonna, you know.
Yeah.
So e-bike will be sweet.
Hello, Kristen.
So you broke the news about Malcolm's injury this week. I saw it.
Wow.
You beat me to it.
He broke his foot at...
Left foot, shifter.
Right after Oakland or something, right?
Yep. You confirmed it. I didn't.
Huh?
You confirmed it. I didn't.
Did I scoop you?
You scooped me.
Oh.
Like yeah,
I wasn't even pushing for it. He just told me.
Yeah.
You know?
Isn't it nice when it comes naturally?
It just comes out.
Yeah. Good for you.
How's the year so far?
I'm enjoying it.
Are you?
Telling good stories. Yeah, I'm going to miss a few coming up because I move over to American Flat Track after this, but I know.
Flat Track. Flat Track's cool, though.
It's badass. It's so cool.
So many passes happen, huh?
So many passes, a lot of lead exchanges. We have TTs, we have short tracks, we have
The mile is the gnarliest thing ever. People don't understand.
Well, and at home it doesn't do it justice. Like, when you stand in turn one off the straightaway, like lap two at Springfield, you feel it. It's crazy.
Yeah.
So much fun.
I remember when I was at Cycle News, you know, reporting
you
on the miles.
Some?
Well, you know, I'd have to like take notes on what happened in the miles. Yeah. There's like 75 passes for the lead in a mile race, you know?
They were
so
going like six wide.
Yeah.
Off turn four.
It was pretty crazy.
It's gnarly. It is still so cool. So I'll be popping over there, but I'll still be here for sometimes. How is your season going?
My season's going okay.
Who's your favorite to talk to this year?
Oh, Oh, Malcolm, of course, always. Yeah. Malcolm's fun. Everybody's fun. Dude, that guy right there.
This year, yeah.
He's having a good time this year. He's easy to talk to.
Very, very fun to talk to.
Is this race the breast cancer awareness race you're doing?
No, but
why is everyone wearing pink?
Because Valentine's Day is Monday, did you?
Oh, is that why he's wearing pink gear with hearts?
You're going to be in the doghouse, huh?
Huh?
You forgot Valentine's Day is Monday?
No, I knew it was Monday.
I don't think there's a correlation. I asked him about that. I'm like, hey, is there anything behind the gear? And he was like, no.
Yeah, Chase is wearing pink, too.
Oh, is he? No, that's not pink. That's like fuchsia.
Oh, okay, my sunglasses.
That's fuchsia and, like, purple.
So what are you doing on Valentine's Day?
I am...
Is there a better half of the...
There is.
There is?
There is a better half. I don't know. We haven't really talked about it yet. We're not, like... Valentine's people. You know what I mean?
Okay. This is just another Monday.
No, we'll probably do something, but like not like the, you know, champagne and all that. Like the
flowers and
flowers. No. We're like horse people, like probably go like ride the 50s and like call it a night or something. Monday's my off day, so we hang out.
Nice. Enjoy
Monday's
it.
Your off day, right?
Every day's my off day, come on.
Right, okay.
How is your shit dirty already, dude? Did you do morning press?
No, I, are you serious or you know?
Well, you got dirt on your number plate. Your boots are dirty.
I just predicted the Super Bowl. You missed it.
What?
You didn't hear the bikes before? Me and Adam?
Uh-uh.
We just predicted who would just won the Super Bowl, so.
Oh, so you came out and did something for TV already.
Yeah.
So that's why you're dirty.
The jersey, like I had Joe Burrow's and he had Stafford.
Oh, okay.
And then somebody won, but we don't know.
Yeah. All right. So, did you have to go to media training? You know, Mr. Controversy here? What do you think? Does he have to go to media training?
I don't know. I don't have the answer to that question.
Well, Suzuki used to be big on that.
Yeah.
Like, make their riders go to media training. Mr.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know? So, if I wear my Let's Go Brandon sweatshirt.
You can wear them.
I can wear it. Yeah, they just can't.
Wear one. Huh? We can't.
I wore it in a podcast and people were happy.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, people are just supporting me, you know.
Yeah.
Just
supporting you.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know what else it stands for. It's
like yeah.
Let's exactly.
Sam.
Let's go, Brandon.
When people are, you know, it's cool when people are in the crowd cheering me on, you know. Seriously.
When are you gonna make a merch shirt that says "Big Sexy"?
That ain't a bad idea.
Huh? Yeah.
I think that name's good for me.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like.
How do you feel about having your rider with the nickname Big Sexy?
I mean, he's big sexy, right?
Is he?
I think so.
No, I hope he does well.
Okay, sir. You're going home after this round?
Wednesday.
Are you coming back?
I would like to. If I can make some money and then I'll try to come back. Okay. But if not, I'm going to be back working and then I'll be back November again.
Working? What's the work at home in the UK?
Well, I'm training to be a stuntman, so...
That's
so
good.
I'm here, and I have to be here, so...
Ah.
Climbing the ladder.
Is it motorcycle stunts or all stunts?
I'm doing learning all stunts.
Oh,
so that's
wow.
Like I'm learning the skills, you know?
So you kind of have the skill of crashing, right? You know how to tumble and all
I
that.
I do, kind of, but like... As people say that to me all the time, but when you crash racing... Mm-hmm. It happens, doesn't it? When you crash for real, it's like you can slow it down a little bit, but no.
So all stunts with the emphasis on two-wheeled stunts, right?
Yeah, at the moment, yes. Learning fighting skills and all that type of stuff, so yeah. Okay.
And so you're going to land, excuse me, not COVID. You're going to land and go straight to Nando's?
Oh, yeah. You asked me.
I remember that,
Me and my girlfriend will go Nando's. I love it there.
So somebody commented on YouTube that there's Nando's in the States.
There is.
Is it a different one or is it the same?
No, it's the same, but it's only one. There's only one in like the whole, but I don't know where it is.
Oh.
I think Jason knows. Jason Anderson knows where it is.
Because
I know he goes there when he goes like, I don't know what race it's at.
Yeah. And so we talked about the mushy peas thing, right?
Yeah, that's sweet.
So you can find mushy peas in the United States, but they're in a can.
Yeah.
Not the same, right?
Kind of. Do you know Annie's?
No.
Annie's has a like a British menu, and you can have fish and chips with mushy peas.
Is there Annie's in California?
Yeah, it's in Temecula.
Oh, I'm finding it.
Yeah,
sure.
And they have a British breakfast, full English.
Yeah.
It's like a real sausage.
Yeah. Banger, what do they call it? Bangers and...
Bangers and mash.
Mash and bangers.
Well, you know you have streaky bacon?
Uh-huh.
We have like bacon that's like that, and it has like a little towel of fat.
Oh.
So it's different. But they do it with like the full English.
Okay. So what would you say is the best thing about this US trip that you've taken this year?
The sun.
Yeah, you know what? I told you, I went riding with Bernard Kerr.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, I'm going home next week. And I look at his Instagram now and he's riding in the mud.
Oh man.
It's just so gloomy.
He's keen though. Like it'll be raining and he'll still be out there like busting all the jumps.
Yeah.
He's keen.
He's psycho. Keen. You ever go riding with him back home?
No, he always messages me, but I'm a bit scared because like I don't want to go with him. Because he's going to be like, why are you not jumping the jumps? It's easy. I jump the supercross jumps. I'm like, it's not the same, though, is it?
Yeah.
But no, maybe soon.
Right on. Well, good luck this weekend and safe travels home, yeah?
Yeah, cheers, mate.
And when you come back, bring me some mushy peas.
Yeah, I will.
Don?
Yeah, we are. All right. Did you like it? It looked good, huh? It was tasty.
When you did the poll, like broken or not broken, I was like, yeah, for sure.
You voted broken?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Because it was now. Like, this thing was like even bigger. So I was like, yeah, we're not going to see Don on the mountain bike, but it feels good. G got you right.
G did the magnet, but I went right from the hospital to the cryo tank at this Ohana fitness place.
Yeah, yeah.
And came.
Well, yeah, came if it was just down. Swollen and inflamed, I mean, nothing's better for that than the cold.
Yeah, I did the cryo like four times this week. And apparently, your wiener's not the only thing that shrinks in that full tank, right?
Like, swelling, bro.
It's swelling. Swelling. Yeah. So, triple crown, felt good.
Yeah,
did it feel
wild.
Like, you know, you came into this year knowing you could win, right? And then see, it took a while to get it done because you've been like unhappy guy on the podium.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
But how did that feel compared to your first win?
Nowhere near the same. No, I'll be real. Like, it honestly, after the race, like, it didn't even feel like I won it because it was like, you know, moto scores, it was like outdoors, like two motos for one overall, and now it's like three. So it's just, you just feel like repeat, repeat, repeat. And then you're like, okay, we won. No, we didn't. We got this point, you know. So it was kind of like, I knew I won. I knew where I was in the last moto. I knew where I had to be to get the win. And it was just no one between me and Christian. Beat him or be right behind him. So we were in a pretty safe position from when we passed Vince in the last one. So yeah, I mean, it was good, but again, it didn't feel like a traditional win.
You didn't go home and celebrate with a big glass of Milo?
No, not really, mate. We've just got different goals this year. Yeah. You know, we have different goals. We want to be on the box every single round, which we didn't accomplish last year. We have so far this year. Mm-hmm. And dude, we want that championship. So
yeah,
that's
only nine points now, right?
Eight.
8 points.
Eight. Big difference. Eight and nine. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But dude, that's just like, it's just how it is. Like, we work our ass off, and you know, some people might be like, oh, why is he grumpy on the first few rounds with podiums and stuff? And it's almost just like, dude, I want it so bad, and we work so hard for it, and it's right there, you know. So
what is the missing ingredient?
Our starts haven't been the best. They were better in the triple crown, but 10 minutes, it's hard, you know, me and Christian and even Michael and a few other guys, for the first 10 minutes of a main, you know, everyone's really close in pace, you know, so it's tough when it's just short sprints where it's not a massive physical side of deal. It's tough to pull in seconds and stuff on that.
What do you think about the break coming up? Are you in favor of it, or does it piss you off?
I like it. No, I mean, it doesn't piss me off because I know I can. It's a good little break, good little breather. It's. I like the West Coast. I can, you know, do some longer duration stuff, kind of like half. Put my, you know, finger in the pie for outdoors, get that a little bit going, and then you know, back to Supercross for the last few weeks of the break, and come back, and then hopefully do some damage. So.
That saying you just used, it seems so like, for lack of a better word, like sexual.
What do you mean?
You get your finger in the pie.
Oh, you know, you just dip your finger in the pie of outdoors and like, it's, yeah, I don't know, it's not sexual.
So are you looking forward to getting some outdoor testing?
Yeah, it should be good. We did all our testing last year at the end on the new bike to kind of get a head start because it was a new bike and stuff. And so I'm excited. It should be good. We have a good base from where we left off from the outdoors on this new bike. The engine's obviously getting better and stuff. And yeah, dude, just get some motos in, some longer motos, go suffer on the outdoor track, and then you know, get back in, give Jet some business on the practice track.
Yeah.
Get ready for, I think it's Atlanta we come back at, I believe. If I'm.
I think so.
Or is it Denver? Atlanta or Denver? I don't know. There's but two one of them. Yeah, one of them. So.
Okay. So yeah. Tell me about the gear. Is this like Valentine's Day gear?
This the feeling cute, might delete later gear, you know? Yeah, a little, just a little, you know, something different. Again, not everyone wants to be in these colors. Not everyone would wear this or like it. Dude, it's just fun. It's fun. It's me. It's unique.
Yeah.
Little Valentine's Day happens to tie in good. Just It's a vibe, so.
So is Cynthia in town right now for Valentine's Day?
She is. She flies out Sunday though.
Oh.
Yeah, she's out of here. Yeah, she's out of here. She wanted to leave home. She's missing Milo.
Yeah.
I miss him too, but I said I can't fly home that early after a race. I'm like, six weeks. I don't have to be ready for a race next weekend. I just want to chill, play a little golf, watch a Super Bowl. I don't want to be traveling and just, you know, pack all the stuff. I got to take car back, the truck back to Jared's, you know, packaging my mountain bike up, sending that to Florida. So I got some stuff to do. We'll be back for Monday. We'll be back in action Monday.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, everybody, I hope to see you smiling.
I'll be smiling. Saturday night. Unless something bad happens, I'll be smiling. I'll be smiling. I can like reassure it. I'll be up there cheesing.
Okay.
Awesome.
Yeah. You do look cute.
Thanks, bro.
Man, I heard you were doing wheelies up the street on a dual sport.
On a dual sport or the electric bike?
Yeah, the free ride.
Yeah, electric. Go ahead and I'm with my Tia.
Yeah. So you're.
My Tia show up to my house and it was pitch dark.
Yeah.
And we still went on the ride,
on the
you know.
Does the free ride have a headlight?
Yeah, they have headlights. But still, it's sketchy, you know, when you go off those dirt roads, you know, there's rocks everywhere, but we had a good time.
So you went up Bedford Canyon?
Yeah, we did, yeah.
Ooh. Bedford is no fun. Was it more fun on the
free
ride?
Those bikes, they are, yeah.
Did you take the optional single tracks?
No.
No, stayed on the fire.
Yeah. Dude, it was like nighttime.
Yeah,
it
was safe and sane.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's calling me. He's all, where are you? Where are you, Mom?
I know, we wanted to stop by house.
Yeah, I was in Pasadena.
I know, you told me. I don't know, I shouldn't say that on camera, but we went down to the restaurant where he works with those bikes. So, on the road.
Yeah.
Anyway, we had a good time.
Yeah, that restaurant's good, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so we're checking in with Cooper Webb. Defending Supercross champion. Seems like the year is not gone exactly the way you would hope for. Started off with a bang, the podium. But how are you feeling?
Yeah, it obviously hadn't been a perfect start, no doubt. Up and down for sure. But we're working through it. You know, we're getting better every week, and you know, we're still in the mix, which is all you can ask for. So been working hard, trying to figure stuff out and make the most of it Saturday and try to get back up front where we belong.
Okay, so the preseason hype you heard was Cooper so pumped on the bike, right? The new bike, all new chassis, motor, everything. Obviously racing is different than testing. Is it something you're searching for now still, or is it just you trying to find your flow?
We have a good platform, no doubt. Yeah. It's just, you know, finding comfort with myself, and when you go racing, you do learn a lot. So, you know, that's the beauty of racing is you never know where you're at until you actually go racing. So I think, it's been a little bit of a up and down getting some stuff figured out as far as settings and stuff like that. But, you know, it is what it is. Everyone's in the same situation. So we've been making the most of it and made... you know, some good stuff happens, so hopefully we can make it work on Saturday. Mm-hmm.
So we, you know, us journalist kooks, we got to test the bike last week. And, you know, for an average guy on a motocross track, it's uppercase amazing, right?
Yeah.
Like, it's such an amazing platform. When we put out this test and say, dude, the bike is unreal. And immediately the comments are like, oh, the Supercross guys, they're struggling. Da, 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 da. But I mean, it's totally feasible to have a great platform for motocross that works differently for Supercross, right?
Yeah, I mean, it is tough, like you said. It's something we're learning. I think this platform, like you said, this bike is really amazing. It's just getting the most out of it, and then especially in Supercross. So, you know, I think it's capable of very, very good things. We just gotta kind of work on it and figure out what works and what doesn't. But I know the group of people that are around me are not gonna stop until we get where we need to be.
Mm-hmm. I'm still anxious to see the little scrapper.
The scrapper. Yeah. Me too. I think we're gonna be back this weekend.
Nice. Are you looking forward to the series leaving the West Coast? I mean, I know usually people are just like, I just want to get out of the crappy California conditions.
Yeah, I mean, Cali is definitely tough. You know, you always get the hard pack conditions. So I'm excited to get back east. I gel well there, but, you know, we still got some business to handle in the West.
Mm-hmm. Cool. I know you got married. Is there dad life on the horizon anytime soon?
I'm not sure, man. You know, it's...
never know, you know, but so far it's been good. What, over a year and a half now married, so yeah, never know.
Little Coopers. Did you know that Warriors bleed too?
Yeah, dude. Motivation.
Big career moves, Corey Flewellen. So, you know, you had to trade all the blue in for orange.
That was a big swap, getting emptying the closet, because it was all black and green Monster stuff, and black goes really well with like any normal day clothing, so I could wear it all the time. This bright orange stuff, you can't just wear it into a grocery store.
You can't wear orange casually.
No, absolutely not. So it's a weekend and at work only.
Yeah. Did you really wrap your Tesla orange?
No, unfortunately I sold it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I sold it to my brother. He's a lucky guy now.
Did you remote control it over to him when you handed it over?
No, but I still have control of it in the app, so I can see where it's at.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm good. Are there any special colorways tonight?
We're going to be using some of the same colors we used for the last couple weeks, mixing it up a little bit. So you'll see some mango
out there.
Pink and blue? No. No cotton candy today.
No cotton candy?
No. Mango.
Mango.
Yeah.
Oh, the orange and...
Some guys will have the orange and some guys will have the black.
Oh, nice.
But next week at Minneapolis, we'll be dropping a new colorway of that.
When are you coming out with the black and green that I saw little Keith wearing? He told me that's a signature.
What you're talking about. I don't recall seeing that.
Brock had it too, and I commented to Brock. That's the little Kiefer line.
It's the special in-house Kawasaki colors that we produced for little Kiefer, and then Brock joining Kawasaki, we thought it would be good for him too.
32 large headed to Corona, please.
Okay, I'll put that in right away. You know someone could wear it and rock it?
Oh, I do.
Yeah. We'll make it happen.
Yeah. Anything new and exciting for FXR on the horizon?
Well, we have this goggle that's going to be coming out real soon.
Oh, sister company. I've seen it on Alex, right?
Alex Martin and Marchbanks and Nicoletti and Jace Owens and a bunch of guys, Lopes.
And what does the strap say? Race?
Or factory ride.
Factory ride.
Yeah. And that'll be available in about 5-6 weeks.
Yeah, no, it's a great goggle.
All the media.
I've worn it in the other capacity. It's an amazing goggle.
Yeah, well, it's even better.
Yeah.
Even better.
Cool, with your strap.
Well, it's got some cool little hits on it. It's like the, I'm not gonna say the Cadillac of the other goggle, but we put a little effort into it. But the chassis of it is sick. It's awesome. Yeah. It's awesome.
Awesome.
So that is what's new right now. But we've got a couple more drops happening this year with some cool colors that I think will work well with that swap guy. I think he'll appreciate it. I'll have to give him a call and get him all set up. And then our...
Hey, you know what? The DJ Khaled gear did me dirty, man. It was bad luck. It sent me to the ground. I mean, look at my arm. I was too distracted by the palm trees.
Sales went up that week.
Did it?
Sales went up that week. So everybody wants the tropical gear, which is nice. But yeah, our 23 stuff, we built it and it's getting made, and you guys will get a sneak peek a little bit later. But
nice.
We're really excited of the new 23 line. We got some sick new 6D colors coming out too.
Mm-hmm.
One will be dropping for Minneapolis.
Oh, great.
So, I'll talk to the swap guys and maybe they can share that information with you.
I just said to Jason, there is no way that that's Alex's friend.
Wait.
Are you here for Alex?
I am.
But you're not here for like the A-Ray Tinder tour, right?
I don't think so,
no.
I didn't sign up for that.
Can you come by his bike real quick? What is it about Alex that captivates you?
Huh? I really like his smile, sense of humor.
His smile and sense of humor. He does have a good sense of humor.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah. And are you from Tennessee as well?
I'm from Kentucky.
Kentucky.
Originally, yeah.
And he is all proud. He is telling me
that he had this friend. You're half Japanese?
I'm a quarter.
Quarter?
Quarter.
You're quarter, so you're Kwapa.
Yes.
Right? Now Hapa is Kwapa. Hapa. Right? Okay. So you're here from Kentucky to watch Alex
I
not
am.
Race.
I've got a little 48-hour trip.
Is he racing?
He's not.
He's not racing because his wrist hurts.
Yes. He's pretty beat up about it. So.
He's what?
He's pretty beat up about pretty it. Beat so up I'm trying it? To give him a little bit more support.
Oh, okay. So you'll like hold his hand during the race and maybe rub his wrist
back,
a little bit?
Rub his back, rub his wrist, whatever he needs.
Okay. What else is it about Alex that you find so charming? His ability to break motorcycles?
He's only been trying to, you know, he's been sliding in my DMs for probably 4 years.
4 years?
But for, in his defense, I have known him for a very long time.
Yeah, so. Like from, I don't want to say childhood, but like, yeah?
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah?
Probably since I was like 13.
13?
Yeah, so that's like 16 years?
Wow.
Goodness,
how much older is
that? 2 years.
2 years. So did you guys go to school together?
Nope. My brother raced many, many moons ago.
Okay.
So we're always at the track. We're on the same team.
This is a meeting of the minds.
I don't want anything to like GoPro, cameras. That's not my thing.
Why not? Don't,
not your thing?
Why?
Oh.
What? You have something to hide?
Yeah.
What? Is there some top secret agent talk
going
on here?
Yeah, yeah. You don't even want to know what G and I were talking about.
No reason to hide.
G, don't say a word.
I don't say it. It's secret.
It's secret until you get on his table. No. Then he just flaps his
lips. It's a secret until you get to his office and then everything is out there.
Doctor patient confidentiality.
Oh, there's
everything comes out.
No.
Hey, you don't want to know
even know what that means.
Hey, he was surly guy this week. I came in to see him and he had no time for lip flapping. He was all business.
Yeah, but your arm looks a lot better.
All business, yeah. His magic magnet works wonders.
Magnet works wonders.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's a secret. Only the best know about it.
So, G, how often do you get guys coming in and saying, I want to go in this private room because I don't want anyone to know I'm here to hurt?
You know, that's pretty funny. It all started back in the day. I actually stopped working with James because I think James would come to the office and he was kind of a secretive guy and didn't want other people to think that he was hurt or to know what body, you know, they'd look over and go, oh, G's working on his, you know, elbow or his ankle or whatever. But I think those days have kind of gone by. Everybody kind of knows that, you know, people make a pit stop during the week, come in the office, just get tuned up, and it doesn't always necessarily mean you're injured.
Yeah.
You know what I like about the private room the best?
What's the private room?
Well, like those little privacy rooms.
Uh-huh.
It's when you got a dad bod, no one else. All the athletes that are on the tables can't see.
That is true.
Yeah, dude.
Belly. You know how you
when I went
that?
In there last for the huge hematoma on my thigh, he had me in the middle of everyone, and I had like my pants off and my ass out, and people were taking pictures.
You know how you fix that? Don't have a dad bod.
Got Dylan Woodcock coming out. Did you find one?
I found the teepee, the toilet, everything.
A gump? You
even,
found one?
Even got some stickers
you
on
got
it.
Got stickers for your pipe?
Yeah, mate, ready to go. Last one, should be fun.
Yeah. So, let me ask you something. I'm not hip on style because I'm 53 years old, right? The shorts are pretty short. Is that a UK thing or is that how it is now?
No, they're just pretty short. I need to shave the old legs though, I can't lie. But other than that, it's all right. Don't know if I'm going to hit the rave, go running, or train in one or the other.
One of the three.
Yeah.
So this is your last race with the big A right there behind you. We got framed up with you.
Yeah, mate. So it's amazing. It's been a dream of mine to come here and make the main here. So hopefully we can do it tonight.
So I can build it.
This is Roger Larson, the media mogul from the Bubba's World podcast.
What's up, Dom?
So do you fly to Florida like every couple weeks and knock out a pod?
Yeah, it was tough. We flew home Sunday from Phoenix.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then right back to the airport Monday morning. flying all day Monday, film all day Tuesday, then fly back Wednesday. In the office on Thursday and then at the stadium again Friday.
Do you and James plan out what you're going to talk about or are you just going to shoot from the hip?
I mean, we probably should plan it out a little bit more, but it's loosely structured, and then we just kind of shoot from the hip.
He's getting into it.
bit way more into it than I thought he would, for sure. Yeah, it's cool. I said in the last one, it just gives, like, watching the races a whole different dynamic. I don't know, like, when I'm sitting in the stands, I'm literally, like, thinking what we could talk about, or, you know, take things out to mention to him later, but it's pretty cool.
Are you going to start selling ads in the podcast? Maybe we could buy a Swapmoto Live ad in there.
Maybe we'll do a trade-off.
A trade-off. Okay.
Yeah, I like that.
All right. Sounds good.
Hey, man. Don't walk away from me.
That's crazy.
Malcolm, you just leaving your manager, your social media manager behind.
Oh, I didn't even know.
No?
It's a calling. Hot day out here, though.
I was like, what's up with that? We're leaving California on a 90-degree day.
Yeah, it's in a way it's nice, just because it kind of reminds me of Florida, but I don't like the dry heat, though. So.
You're right.
But, hey, it is what it is. We're here at A3, so we're going to try to leave here on a good note, go back east. I'm ready to go back home, though. Starting to get a little homesick, so it's be good to go back home for me.
You know what the one good thing about a warm Anaheim 3 is? The boobies will be out in the pits later.
That's true. That's 100% true. A lot of that, back sweat, butt sweat, all kinds of nothing but sweat.
Hey, Jalik, pull your shirt up. Pull your pants open.
That's like Miami.
Flexing with the yeah. So, yeah.
No, it hurts still. It hurts still.
What's under the band-aid?
Boo-boo?
Yeah?
From Monday. We ain't even gonna talk about Monday. Huh? We ain't even gonna talk about that.
Is that the way kids wear their pants now?
No, I was about to get undressed and then I came out here because my shoes were too muddy. So I'm like half undressed right now.
Oh, okay.
I know you hot in those pants.
Oh, yeah.
I was gonna say, I know you. Yeah. Says you don't say they ain't breathing, though.
Oh, yeah. But they told me you have to have pants.
No.
Yeah.
They say those black shorts or pants that don't have holes in them, which...
Those ain't holes, those are ripples.
Those are stretch.
Yeah, these are just like moto
pants. That's to help you get down on your knees easier.
Sonya, you guys are talking to me like that? Come on, man. Nah, that's Mookie's conversation.
Oh, okay, yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's how he talks when the buddies are around.
Okay, you and your little butt buddies on Xbox.
You had to go all the way to truck to just pick up that. Yeah, that bag's empty.
I know.
There's
tell
nothing
about
in it.
I know. It's like about five of them in there. That's enough.
What is it? Candy? Cough drops?
I don't know. Stuff he puts in his drink.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, it's serious training stuff.
Oh, yeah. On Eldon.
Okay.
Specialties.
Okay, Mom. What has it been like watching him just turn into this, like, super fit, sculpted athlete?
I don't know. I don't look at it no different. He's still my baby.
Yeah, you can't tell. I mean,
I can tell for sure.
When he sent me the picture of him in his bicycle kit, I was like, dang, dude.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah.
Dang, dude.
Yeah.
Does he?
Eldon ain't playing, that's for sure.
So does that mean he can't come home for home cooked meals now? He's got to eat his box meal?
Well, he's in Orlando majority of the time anyway. Yeah.
No, but like, you know, it's good to come home and have mom's cooking, right?
Yeah, but he'd be so tired after that. He have to leave it elder. He don't want to come my way.
Oh, it's too far.
He don't want to come my way at all. But when we have family get together, he does. He really enjoys it.
Was he good on Christmas and Thanksgiving?
Awesome. Yep.
I mean,
Eldon killed
the...
him before then. He killed him.
Oh, okay. But he was able to eat the mashed potatoes.
He was able then. Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, I think it was Thanksgiving, he had to ride. They had to do like a 3-hour bike ride, I think, on Thanksgiving day or something like that. Yeah, because Eldon was like, dude, I know you guys are going to eat that. So,
burn the calories before you take a meal, right?
But he's really good still with that. Mm-hmm. Even when we have food at the house like that, you know, holidays, he still makes sure he eats good.
So, were you in Glendale last weekend?
Yes.
So, how did it feel seeing him get his career best?
It was great. I was nervous. But
dude, his starts are coming around.
Yeah. I was more nervous for the third one than anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I knew, like, you know, everybody was just gonna try to hold it on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then if you didn't do good in the first one, those guys there, I was like, they probably gonna be up there in the third. So it was just a matter of just staying up, you know, and stuff. Mm-hmm. So I was super pumped.
So, is Malcolm a appreciative, gracious son? Does he take care of Mama for everything you've done for him as a child?
As a what? I mean,
like,
yeah,
I mean, because like, I'm noticing right now that your phone.
Oh no, because I don't ask Malcolm for anything.
That's he should see that, and that's the
problem they always have during the holidays. They always ask me like what I want. Actually, they bought me a washer and dryer for Christmas.
Oh,
like, I didn't even need it. Like,
wait,
he tried to buy me one last year, and it was like messed up. And so I never reordered one. So he got it this year while he was out in California, and he was like, "Hey, you gonna get it delivered for Christmas?" I'm like, "What? Why? I don't need a washer and dryer, but okay."
That's a risky present to buy your mom, because one time I bought my mom a vacuum cleaner and she got mad at me. She was like, so I could vacuum your mess?
No, it's just, I don't know. He'd been trying to get me one for the last 3 years, so he finally succeeded in that. But as far as talking about my phone,
that's just the cover.
It's just the cover, yeah. And I keep ordering the cover and I keep dropping it. So it doesn't matter to me. I mean, what, $3?
Yeah.
To have them, you know, it's a warranty, lifetime warranty. So
yeah.
Yeah. I mean, in my case, I'll be doing this every month.
Cooper Webb warming up. Only the best in warm up, Carol.
Hold on. Did I get it right?
Cooper's helmet. What do you like better, though? Dark one? Oh, knocks on the roof. Which one do you like better, the white piping or the black piping?
The black one's all new, so
is it?
Hadn't seen it yet, so just they're always sick. Yeah. Red Bull Bell makes them killer always.
Mm-hmm. I love the 10 too.
All thanks to this guy. Yeah. It's hot here today, so we had to take the shirt off.
Yeah. That guy. It's sad that even heroes bleed, right?
Heroes feel pain too.
You know, I think people don't know there's no such thing as a California roll in Japan.
Oh.
Right?
We don't have rolls, just normal sushi.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So when you come to California, you're like, what the hell is a California roll, right?
Yeah, that's why every time I eat sushi in California, I never order sushi. I always order roll. It's good. I love it.
Americanized.
It's good, yeah.
Whoa. Hold up. Let's see it. Let's do the spin, dude.
My finger?
Huh? Oh, shit. Right? It was a good decision?
Yeah, I think so.
Are you still doing it?
Not right now, but I might go on again, yeah.
Okay,
I'd like to lose another 5.
Another 5. So you're down to 170 something?
171, 172.
What?
So,
nice.
From 193.
Feeling good?
Yeah, I feel good.
Feeling
good?
Wait, I heard some nonsense that Kristen is doing it too.
No.
Because she don't.
No.
Yeah, okay. All right.
No, so just me. I needed it.
So did you get to fit in some old clothes that you...
I wouldn't say old, but they fit better.
Fit better?
Yeah, I got to wear a belt.
Yeah, right? I had to go buy a belt. Did you have to go down in canvas pant size?
Well, they actually fit right now. I'm not a sardine.
Hey, dude, that kit that you guys made, Chase, is fire.
Yeah, no, it turned out really well.
And that's like one of the standard options?
That's standard option, yeah. We're still waiting on you to wear yours, you know, so.
Well, dude, mine is like
way
too big now.
You can smell the shit through your ribs now.
Mine's way too big now, so I
know. Yeah,
actually, if we could make a Swapmoto Live one based on Jace's, it'd be sick.
We can do anything you want, Don.
Yeah.
Michael, you hear that?
Huh?
He wants a Swapmoto Live kit like Chase's.
Yeah, there we go. So... Lala wants me to like come out of the closet on my vlog about Optavia. You think I should share it? We should share it with the world?
I think there's some people in our industry that if they can stick to it, the first week's hard.
I think Dahmer needs to do it.
He should do it for sure.
Yeah, but I told him about it. I said I would pay for it and everything. He said, I want to live my life.
Big B. Yeah. I mean, there's lots of guys that could, you know, it would benefit.
Yeah. Dude, you look young again, dude.
man.
I look young again.
Yeah, because you look like
grays that are coming.
You look like an old retired dude for a while.
Stop.
No, you look good.
I am retired. It's been 8 years.
Has it been that long already?
Almost, or yeah, right at it.
Jeez. Seems like the other day we were in Thailand buying Louis Vuittons in some shady little
fake ones.
Some shady little alley.
Yeah.
What?
This is not funny.
What?
This is not.
It's not funny?
Darn, that's fucked up. You bring one to Cooper?
He saw it and asked for it.
He probably did.
I brought you one.
Yeah, cool.
You don't want it?
Yeah, I'll take it because it'll be one less in circulation.
Well, I brought it over. I was waiting for you, but gym driver asked for it.
I'm going to kill myself.
Come on,
John,
dude.
I'm about to walk onto the fucking 57 right now. What is wrong with you? You gave one to Cooper?
He loves it. That just shows. Anyone that's wearing one has deep appreciation for the friendship they share with you.
No, they don't.
No?
No, they just like to bust my balls.
Dude, you don't bust your balls on someone that you don't love. Like, I don't make fun of,
great friends you are. John, you are a... I freaked out when you posted it on your story. Hey, you know who's really fucking dead to me? Dahmer. That dude is done.
Because he's the one who turned it in.
He's done, dude. Huh?
What was going through your mind when you shot that selfie and sent it to Dahmer?
It's like literally, he's asking me how, he's like, are you banged up or whatever? And I sent him a picture because I just gotten home or whatever. Like, what do you mean? That was not like me showing off how tough I am or something. It was Dahmer asking me if I was okay. And then that dickhead sends it to you?
Well, then we got the one from Frankie, too.
Hey, fuck Frankie. That dick.
You know, I've already got some inquiries, like from Fast House. They want to know if they could have the artwork to make a purveyor of good time shirt.
You know that, like, that now I have to, like, switch careers and, like, start over.
Come on. Ben. So, Barak Suzuki with Chris Wheeler. What is this? You have to put candy out for little kids to get people to come look at it.
You gotta bring them in somehow. I don't know.
I'm gonna have a candy.
That's for you.
A dum-dum.
Yeah.
So, how's it going? Arm Army is strong this year, dude.
That's right. Look at the
Carson
setup.
Carson is killing it.
He is. He obviously boneheaded out last weekend, but like...
The little dragon back in.
That was a bummer because like three starts, he's been killing his starts.
Yeah.
So if he could have put three starts with all the chaos that was happening, he could have had a good result. But yeah, he's been good. And then unfortunately, Dylan just can't stay off the ground, which is a problem right now.
Is this Dylan's first Supercross season?
No, he raced last year, but I think he got a ninth. Uh-huh. He actually was running up front at one of the Atlantas and then crashed, but still ended up top 10.
Uh-huh.
So he's got to figure out the Supercross thing because he's not afraid to go for it.
Okay, I've had people come tell me rumors of a 23 Suzuki. Can you confirm, deny, or like wink?
I can't.
You really don't know?
I really don't know. I honestly do not know.
What's going on in Japan? Is there a factory Suzuki effort in Japan or no?
I don't know.
Taichi team still around?
No.
No?
Nope.
Oh, man.
I know he's still helping out because he's just a big-time enthusiast.
Mm-hmm.
He's always been a big backing of the Suzuki program. So I know he still helps out some riders. I just don't think that there's a full race team right now. I know they've been... They had all hands on deck for a minute there for the MotoGP program,
mm-hmm.
and they ended up winning that, so mm-hmm. that showed what they can do. But as of right now, the teams have been doing their thing and doing a really good job.
Dude, it's pretty amazing, like, what great starts Carson's been getting, because if you think about it, like, all the competition has had motor advancements and developments through the years, and
twisted is getting good power out of these things where he's pulling massive starts.
Well, it's funny, I was gonna bet some people, because I know how much they worked coming into the season, mm-hmm. and it's like one of those things where you're quietly optimistic. You don't wanna be like, oh, we're gonna do all this. But I think they've shown, even Dylan, like the first couple rounds, those guys were both top five in a couple of the heat races. Mm-hmm. And I think in Oakland, they both were top 10. I think they were like 5 and 7 mm-hmm. off the start. And Carson hole shot a couple. I think he hole shot the heat that they ended up having the red flag because Schwoll went down in the main, and he was top 3. He was top 3 at San Diego off the start. So, mm-hmm. yeah, the bikes are good.
Right. Have you seen the Carson Mumford clothing company, Mumford Army shirt?
Yeah.
I wear that shirt proudly. It's kind of like a trademark violation on Arm Army, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Just kind of like just bury our head in the sand because you gotta respect it.
Yeah.
I mean, he's working hard. I appreciate it. I appreciate the effort he puts in on that. So hey, you gotta enjoy what you're doing.
Look at this, he's hustling. He's got the merch cards on the autograph table.
He gets that from his dad. I didn't really know his dad that well before.
Oh,
this
his dad's
year.
Like
right.
businessman extraordinaire.
So I seen it. I go, okay, now it makes sense.
You know where it comes
me.
From.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I would love to go to Japan and bring back some spy photos of a new yellow bike. We'll see.
Are you going this year?
Well, dude, the borders are still closed.
How long? Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, they were supposed to do so on the road race side. They were supposed to do some we're doing homologation thing. Mm-hmm. And they end up. I've got to do it here now.
Yeah.
Because they couldn't do it in Japan because of that. So yeah, I guess you're still right.
Yeah. This is Scott Mumford's truck. RM250 that Carson just built. Surprised it's together. It was in a terrible state of disassembly in his garage for a while. Shoddy clamps.
Hi, how are you?
Hey,
I'm Jerry. Dude, I like the Padres at San Diego, right?
Uh-huh, yeah, every kid has been pretty cool. I think Padres is probably my favorite. Uh-huh. Just the brown and the sand color just really popped, and I like that one a lot. But this Lakers kit goes pretty hard, I think.
Yeah, let's see it.
Yeah, I went down, but it turned out pretty good. Back.
What are you doing?
Nice. I think it's sick.
So who's the idea behind all this? Is it you or is it the Canvas guys?
No, so it's not me. It's Michael Lieb and Sam Morton. They own Canvas MX and SKDA. They collab on it.
And Ryan Villopoto.
Yeah, and Ryan Villopoto. So they all collab on it and make the ideas. And the SKDA, Sam, he has all 17 rounds like already pretty much
planned out.
And we're like 5 rounds ahead on printing, gear, all that stuff.
Sick.
Yeah, so it's all planned.
Are you going with local sports teams and everyone?
Yeah, so like Minnesota's going to be pretty cool, I think, for all the Minnesota fans. I can't really let the cat out of the bag yet.
So you're going to do 450 there?
Yeah, I'm doing all 17 rounds.
Oh, sick. Okay,
yeah, and
okay.
Then I'll be 450 class on East.
Yeah.
So
how has 22 been going for you? First of all, is it good to be back on a normal-ass schedule?
Yeah, dude. Honestly, like the fans, like the pits, like everything, it's so fun. So it's nice to be back to normal there. It's just, what's the question again?
Like,
after that.
Like, how's 22 treating
you? Oh, okay, so 2022, it's going all right. Started off with COVID, which was a bummer, and it actually, like, jacked me up pretty bad. Just like lung.
Did you have the Omicron or do you have the real one?
I think it's the original because it like attacked my lungs like really bad. Like I was coughing up like black stuff and literally like my lungs were burning bad. Mm-hmm. So at Oakland I was struggling pretty bad. And even what was after that? San Diego?
Yeah.
I think it was. And even there I was like still like pretty low on energy. Mm-hmm. But I feel better now. Making mains, feel solid, just gotta get off the better starts. That's really what it comes down to.
Okay, so 250 West, 450 East.
Yeah.
What are you better
at? Honestly, everyone says I'm better on a 450,
uh-huh.
Which I personally feel quite a bit faster on a 450, but that's just me. But I like lug the bike, I don't really rev, and I think mm-hmm. that's why I feel better on a 450 compared to a 250.
Yeah.
But.
So who's building your shit?
So RaceTech does the motor. It's just headwork, and then I have ECU and FMF full tie system, and that's it. So my bike's pretty basic. This turns as like mods and motor work and stuff, but it's still like stock piston, everything, all that.
What was easier to set up suspension for, 250 or 450?
250, just because you can like hammer stuff. Like 450, you really gotta like actually try to dial in your bike, which for me, like I've never grown up being that way. You just kind of like ride what you get, you know? And so getting used to the 450 has been tough in that sense, like actually setting zig, messing with clickers and stuff like that. Like usually I just wing it. And, but I like the 450 a lot. It's a lot of fun.
So Vegas, final round, you're gonna be in black and silver?
For Vegas? Between Salt Lake?
Or not, but is there a Vegas? Oh, there's no.
No, there's no Vegas.
See, I don't even look at the schedule. I know.
I wish there was. The new stadium was badass.
Yeah.
That's what I was hoping for, but it is what it is. But I think, so the final round in Utah, we're doing the Jazz, and those colors are always cool.
Yeah. Sick. Yeah. Well, good luck tonight.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Oh, there
this
he is.
This thing is finally here. How long have you been talking about the Hitch Hotel?
Sadly, 8 years, buddy.
8 years.
Yeah, but this with the wheels on, it's been 2 years.
Nice.
Yeah, and there it is.
Okay, give me the premise. It compresses down to that little front piece.
39 inches when it's closed. That tongue flips up and goes away. When it's open, it's 7 feet, 2 inches long. It's vented for AC and heat. It's got onboard power. That rack underneath, we'll put a bike on the front, bicycles on the back.
Bike on the front instead of this basket.
Yeah, all this does is unpin. That unpins and goes away.
Nice.
Yeah,
Let me see inside this thing, Jeff. So Jeff here is, whoa, dude.
7 feet two, check it out.
Garth Milan could land here.
We had a 6 foot nine guy in here, and he had all the room in the world.
Yeah,
so it's vented for AC and heat. It's got a fan here with a light. It's got onboard power. It's got a little storage thing here. When it closes up, all this becomes usable space.
Oh, nice.
When it's closed.
Yeah.
So, and this is what it looks like when it's completely folded up. That's what it looks like.
Nice.
Yeah.
So there. Oh, good. Okay. So that's a comparison.
That's a comparison. Yeah. Yeah. 12 feet.
Yeah. And so you could pull this behind a car.
Well, we're thinking about buying a smart car right now to put it behind a smart car to advertise with it behind a smart car. This is my partner, Gil. This is Dominated. This is Swapmoto. This is the man right here. Come on.
So for history's sake, Jeff Patterson is the man who brought the Liat brace to the United States, a visionary in our sport. And
put it on you,
a good buddy, and we've been talking about this for a while. I'm so stoked to see it come to fruition.
Yeah.
So is it available now?
It'll be ready to go in June. It's being manufactured right now. There's a lot of supply chain problems over where we're having it manufactured. The frames are being made in Foshan, China, and the shells and the doors are being made here. So it'll be ready to go in June. We're starting to take pre-orders here pretty quick. We just got back from SEMA. We were voted the top 10 most innovative product.
I saw that. Yeah, that's sick,
it
dude.
Turned out pretty good.
We're super happy for you.
Yeah.
We're going to have to borrow one and do some
testing,
content.
For sure.
And do some adventuring.
For sure. Yeah, for sure.
It's funny because you look at it from the side and you see how it gets smaller.
Yeah.
But then you look at it from the inside and it looks huge.
Well, it is huge. And that is the thing that plays with people. When they see it, they're like, what is this thing? Mm-hmm. When I show them how it opens, they're like, holy crap. Then when they look inside, they're like, man, this thing's huge in here. And when I first climbed in it, I was like, it's big.
Yeah.
Because there is a lot of room.
So what would you suggest, an air mattress inside?
So air mattress, or they make, or you can,
a foam
pad. They make a foam pad that you can vacuum pack down.
Yeah.
You don't want to have a lot of stuff in there because it needs to all kind of go away.
Yeah.
This carrier here is so you can put an AC unit, a heating unit, gas cans.
They make a portable AC unit that goes
totally, floor? Totally. Yeah. And it's vented right here. The vent system comes through here, and you plug your AC or your heat right into here, and your onboard battery is right there.
Yeah.
So you put a little Honda generator right here. It's got power and for solar panels. So, and you know, this is all going to be modular. This will be able to come off there'll be a kitchen that slides out of here. You'll be able to put a kitchen on it, a bathroom, and a toilet, a bathroom and a shower. So
nice.
We're pretty stoked about
okay,
it.
Okay, so June, you said.
June. It'll be ready June. To go in June.
Retail price, stock.
$9,500 with onboard power.
Nice.
Ready to go. There's options that are going to come out in the future, but these are all fully vented and yeah, it's ready to go, man. After 8 years of working on it, it's been a journey, but
awesome.
Yeah.
Hitchhotel.com.
Hitchhotel.com. Yeah, or Hitchhotel at Hitchhotel for the Instagram. So yeah, thank
awesome.
You, dude.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
This guy trying to get some free shit.
Yeah, bring it to us. I'll take it. Yeah. You
guys on the set.
Stop filming me, dude. You always film me.
I know you love it, man.
Yeah, you always film
dude,
me.
Dude, you are.
What?
Your face is really cute when you're like, trying to work it.
I'm not working anything.
Huh?
I've been with him for freaking 10 years.
If it's green,
is this iCycle?
Exactly.
What?
It's Mr. iCycle. You take the hat off.
Come on, there's only a few bottles left.
I'll come back a little bit.
I was like, are you going to hit him or are you going to flip him off? I don't know.
I'm a Supercross.
Let's go, Brandon.
Dude, it's Brittany. Get it right.
It's Miss
Stop
Supercross.
Being a creeper. It's Brittany.
Okay, Brittany. Oh. Dang, how's the racing going?
Not good.
What?
They're not much.
Dude.
They need to start training, huh?
I saw you like with factory bikes and wearing them out because you're so fast now. Huh? You won a championship, didn't you? You won a race or some big race?
Hey, yeah. So this dude will be going to Lake Elsinore tomorrow to race.
Are you coming?
Swapmoto Live.
No.
Are you racing tomorrow?
Yeah, he's gonna race tomorrow. He's gonna race tomorrow. He brought his bike, everything. He's gonna do it for the dirt bike kids.
Yeah.
No.
You know?
I think so.
I think he should.
His mom's gonna do a 30-second board card.
Maybe.
Right?
Huh? Definitely not. I'm too old for that.
Is he still mad?
Yeah, he's pretty pissed.
Ben, I took my shirt off.
Why'd you change?
I took my shirt off for you. In support.
Thanks.
Look at us.
We're brothers from other cultures.
Look at that.
Stop.
Look at that.
Get out of here.
What happened?
I'm tough.
Yeah, you heal like Wolverine.
Yeah, it's been 3 weeks.
Was that a pair?
So you're gonna tell me about the rotating graphics?
Oh yeah, rotating graphics, you know, it's just something cool we do. We like to switch it up, we like to be different, we like to show the sponsors some love, we like to keep it fresh, you know, it adds suspense to the riders, it adds suspense to us as if we show up on Friday and Saturday, you know, we're like, what kit are we gonna do? Like, what's it gonna look like? Because Chris doesn't show us the kits.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, so he doesn't, we show up on Friday and the graphics are in the truck and we're just like, oh, that's awesome, you know?
So what level of sponsorship of the team has to be met to be one of the rotating titles?
Oh, I'm not entirely sure as to how that.
So this week it's Motul.
Right.
Previously it was I Am a Comeback.
Yeah, I Am a Comeback. And then we did United Planners and Glendale with a Team Solitaire bike on the Focus. And then we did a special edition military graphic. And then the first two rounds we did Nuclear Blast, you know. And then we're going to do a Rob Zombie bike. And then we're going to do a Slayer bike.
Oh,
you
nice.
Know, it's just like continuously switching it up and keeping it fresh. And the fan.
What's your favorite Nuclear Blast artist?
Honestly, I'm gonna have to go with the original Slayer. Yeah. Like, who doesn't love Slayer, man? Come on. Yeah, like, that's a given right there.
There's Yoda right there dropping knowledge. Dude. This jersey, look at this.
Around 97, 96.
Jeez, that thing is black. And it's even got the homemade vents.
That's him, he did it.
I love it. You know, Damon Bradshaw gave me one of those. Not Damon Bradshaw, Jeff Stan gave it to me when he won
Daytona Supercross.
Really, that's sick.
And that was at the time when he told me he would lose 12 pounds during a hard race. And he gave it to me, and the jersey was so heavy. It was wet. And I went and I threw it over my lampshade in my hotel room, and then went to the flat track.
Yeah.
And I came back, dude, my room smelled like an armpit when I got back. It was
he
terrible.
He says he loses about 10 pounds at outdoor, too.
Yeah? He don't have 10 pounds to lose.
I know, it's pretty crazy.
So then he goes down under 100?
It's in his ball weight.
His balls.
Yeah, he's probably like 140.
So are you doing the troll training videos too?
Yeah, pretty much.
So you're like full-time troll guy now.
Yeah, troll for him, and then I did a couple for Jeremy, and then I filmed for Ronnie Mack on the side too.
Ah, okay. I like the most recent Kmart video.
Yeah, it's good. He's like, good. People don't really get his personality on TV, but like he's really awesome. Quirky, yeah, really like hardcore. So.
Well, troll guy again. Your boots don't match your kit.
They don't?
No.
This is the best I got, Don.
They match your bike,
there. Yeah.
I just thought.
What kind of boots should I have?
Black.
I don't have the one Mark Banks has. I don't have that pair.
Bob's a little tight. It's hard to get boots out of Bob.
Yeah. I love Bob, though. He's a Minnesota guy.
So, I just heard you lose 10 pounds in a national.
Oh, really?
You did.
Who do you? I didn't?
In sweat. You say you lose 10
pounds. Oh, well, we did a training day in Florida, during quarantine. And I think I weighed myself before, at the beginning of the day, and then after. And it was
10 pounds.
I don't know if it was exactly 10. Probably 8, at least.
Does that include a giant turd?
No, but that's like literally, I'm eating like probably 3 or 4 bars, a sandwich, and drinking.
Yeah.
And I'm still losing that much weight.
How's things been going?
Pretty good. Yeah, I can't complain. I mean, that practice was absolute dog shit. But for the most part, I've really been enjoying the 450 class. Like, competition-wise, I've never had anything like this in my life.
Yeah.
Like, it's so tight. Like, I can put down what would maybe normally be like a top 5, top 3 qualifying time, and I'm like 12 to 14. And there's literally a bunch of good guys ahead of me. Like, today, actually, was probably the best I qualified. I was like a 10th off of Kenny, 59.3. Like, Chase was a 59.0. We were all like really there. Obviously, Ferrandis was like in the 57s, but if I'm within 2 seconds of those guys, it's usually a good day.
Is Japanese Yoda over there having your bike looking okay?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I've been enjoying testing with your brother Ross. It's been good. I've been in Southern California for this whole swing, so now here for about 6 weeks. Tested with Ross a couple times. It's been fun. I enjoy having him at the track.
Are you looking forward to going back to Minnesota? Are you staying this week or are you going straight home?
I'm going back to Florida for the week.
But I mean, racing.
Well, I'm back in Florida basically from Sunday on for the rest of the series, but I'll fly to Minneapolis. This time of the year, I'm happy to be just there for like 2 days. That's good enough for me.
Good luck tonight.
Thanks, Don.
Jagger, I haven't seen you in a year and a half. How old are you now?
7.
7?
Yeah.
Do you remember that time?
What?
When you pooped near the tree in the front yard?
What? Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, that was like 5 years ago.
No, that was like last week.
What?
That was like last week or something. So how do you like Florida?
Huh?
Do you like living in Florida?
Yeah.
Have you pooped in your front yard in Florida yet?
No.
Not yet? Is that your dad's necklace? Or is that yours?
Yeah.
That's yours? Or your dad's?
Mine, and then it's now. My dad's, now it's mine.
Now it's yours? How's it having being a big brother to two?
Good.
What's your favorite thing about being a big brother?
I don't know.
You don't know? How's the electric 50 riding coming along?
Good.
Have you raced in Florida yet? You used to race in California.
I haven't done a race. Yeah, I haven't done a race. Before.
Not yet.
And now I do the KTM Junior.
Oh, are you? When? Next year?
I don't remember which one. It's the 450. I don't know which one it is.
Ah, okay. Do you already have your dance planned out?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah? Can you show me?
What?
I said, do you have your victory dance planned out?
No.
Not yet?
It's our partner.
Big Don Emler, the legend here.
I'm done.
Huh?
I'm not talking.
How are things? Are you healed up? Are you healthy right now? Because
no.
I know you had like some neck surgery.
No, I was loading my bike and killed myself.
Yeah, I heard you like rode the bike into the back of your cab.
No, I didn't. I rode the bike up till I couldn't reach anymore, and then I got in the truck, and then I straddled the fender, and I hit the starter, and it gave it gas the wrong way, and it fucking flipped me out of the truck into the beep.
Dude, you got flown like a sock.
I was going riding the next day. I was loading the truck. Done.
Okay, future Miss Hartraft here.
Here I am.
How do you feel about the nickname Big Sexy?
I love it.
You love it? Is it accurate?
He definitely lives up to it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Because he was trying to explain what it meant, and he's like, well, my first name starts with a B, and so does Big, and I'm sexy.
Well, have you heard my nickname?
No, what's yours?
Big Country.
Big Country?
Everybody
big Country
calls me
Big
Country.
Sexy?
Yep.
Why
is it
big
country? Because I'm from Alabama.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's hear the accent. Exaggerate it.
Hey, y'all. How you doing?
Okay. It fits.
There you go.
Yo.
Day.
Buster Rhyme.
I don't know.
Dude, what kind of rapper are you?
Fresh. Bro, I haven't been rapping in a while. I've been singing a lot more.
Okay, sing me a line.
I can't. Bro, it's not the day. This is the race day. You know the deal, Swap.
Dude, but come on, dude. A line. You gotta think about it. You're supposed to have this shit.
I don't know what to think about. Ring a ding and dang dang ball. That's the only one
there
I got.
Go.
That's one
good.
Of my favorites.
I'm just going to flap lips.
You gotta do something.
So your wife's nickname is Big Country?
She's right there.
Mm-hmm.
Look at her. She's tough as nails.
Do you remember that song in a Big Country?
Caught Up in the Country?
No, there is a band called Big Country.
Really?
You don't. Oh, well, how old are you? You don't.
23.
Yeah, see, it's too.
She's. So, the only reason she's Big Country is from
Alabama.
There you go. So, I mean, like, that's pretty much like country as it gets, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm from Jersey, where that's completely opposite.
So, does her house, like, instead of having a toilet indoors, it has an outhouse with a moon?
Yeah, she's got a, I'm not in trouble. Nah, she's got a normal house. She's good. But, yeah. I know what you're talking about, though. I've never gone in an outhouse.
No?
And I refuse to.
Just at the track.
You just go to the bathroom in a hole?
I think so.
Have you used one?
An outhouse?
Yeah.
Yeah, in Japan. I was at a mountain camp in Japan once. And it was just a piece of wood with a hole in it and the hole down there.
So think how many butts were sitting on that?
What?
Think how many butts were sitting on that?
Oh, no. They squat in Japan.
So every toilet's clean.
Yeah.
That's nice. Not in America.
We're at Elsinore today. It's Sunday. It's Sunday after Anaheim 3. Swapmoto Race Series, our first trip to Lake Elsinore Motorsports Park. And 7 days after the swollen arm incident. I'm gonna try to see off the ground today, guys. Last week was not good.
See if we can get some motos in.
What do you think, Cootie? Are they gonna water right before our race while we're on the line?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't they?
I should have brought my ice skates.